Hey there, guys. Hey there, YouTube. All the subscribers I have, the few. I just want to get this one out of the way real quick here before I get on the real point of this video. I got a pack today, a miniature box opening, just a quick one, because unfortunately it was only one of the boxes I was desperately awaiting. The other one I still haven't got from Buckeye. Hoping for tomorrow now. I had a good feeling about today, but apparently that was only about this one. This is my, I prepared this earlier. this is my big tobacco acquisition disorder. Hard to cut it. And let's see what we got here. Nope. Packing peanuts. Everywhere. And, let's see. Well, what I got here is a tub of mixture number 79. Because I figure if I'm going to try this out, I may as well go big. And as I understand it, Hugh Hefner smoked this. And, you know, it's worth a shot. And if I hate it, I'll have no problems like giving some away, whatever. May even give you a sample, even if you just ask for it. I mean, it's 14 ounces, so that's a lot of tobacco. And, big old can of Sir Walter Raleigh, because I really like that. And it's a good everyday guy. And, 2 ounces of Billy Budd, just to up my supply. May have to get even more, though, because I like it a lot. A tin of Key Largo, because I was awful curious about this stuff. I love the fedora on there. Dig it. So, you know, I'm judging a book by its cover, and it's got stuff in it that I like. So, you know. And, something I heard so much about, hear about all the time, Peterson's University Flake. So I figured, you know, gotta try it. And one that really got me curious, the first, Lakeland blend that I'll ever try is, Enerdale from Gay with Hogarth. Or Hogarth, whatever. I look forward to this. I think I'll try this one right now. Alright. Yeah. That's what I got. Except for the packing peanuts. Tasty. Alright. Back in a second. Hey guys, back again. And here I am. Smoking my Mastercraft. Bent, deeply rusticated Bulldog. Really great pipe. Don't smoke it often. I usually lay it to flakes because it's a shallow bowl and nicely coned. So it's pretty much perfect for flake. And then there I've got some Enerdale, like I said. I gotta tell you. It's really nice. I do detect a little bit of the soapiness that people talk about. I gotta tell you, I like that. Because I mean, I like Thrills gum. And I'd be offended if Thrills gum tasted like anything but soap. So, I'm also getting a little bit of anise, and a little bit of rose, sure, positive. And underneath it all, there's something else. But, no. Underneath all those flavorings, it could be just tobacco.
Tastes like tobacco!
gotta tell you, Jay, I love it. Love it when you do that. It makes me laugh every time. Look on your face. Perfect. The highlight of my day when it happens. anyway. Yeah, I just watched your video, Jay, on accepting generosity. And, you know, it's not an uncommon problem. I mean, me, I got the same problem. It's not that, I think that there's a catch or anything, it's just that I honestly don't feel like what I've done is worth it. Like, have I done anything to deserve it? I just, really, I've got that problem. But I've been working on it, I've been trying. I still have problems accepting compliments primarily. I've been good about accepting generosity. And I, like, for the people who are generous to me, I try and do everything I can to show them that their generosity was not in vain. It was worth something to me. And I constantly constantly tell them, or show them, rather. I'll never tell them, like, I have a problem with telling people things. Especially things that relate to how I feel. Just the kind of guy I am. I don't make that public, typically. But in my actions and my interactions with them, that's how I show them that their generosity was worth something to me. And that was a lot. And that's really what's important. Because, I mean, as a guy who is generous, I would give you the shirt off my back if I felt you needed it more than I did. Like, I will give anybody things at the drop of a hat. Like, even what I said earlier about sending out, like a sample of Mr. 79 to somebody if they're curious about it after they heard bad things about it. Like, oh, truly. I am just that kind of guy. Like, things are important to me, things have value to me. But what's more valuable to me than these things is the happiness of my friends. Acquaintances, even. Like, being my friend can get you a lot of bonuses. Not that I'm banking for friends here. But, I mean, it's, as a generous guy, truly I don't expect anything in return. I would give you something and never want to ask you for anything back. As, I do place value on myself, naturally. Some. But my time and my possessions, if I have them to spare, I'd give them and never expect anything in return. But I do have a problem accepting things. But I've been working on that. Truly, when someone, a guy like me, offers you something, just take it. Because that's all they want. That's all they want. They want you to have it. Nothing to it. It's just kindness. And you shouldn't use that wood, because what I wouldn't give for a neighbor that had some rock maple in it and offered it to me. Make a great neck for a cigar box guitar, like you were saying you were looking at building. Some rock, like rock maple? Yeah, be great. You wouldn't even need a truss rod if you were using nylon strings. Yeah, Jay. Don't worry about it. Just try accepting kindnesses. I myself have been trying to work on accepting compliments. And building my confidence in myself. Like, that song I posted yesterday. That's a really nerve-wracking thing to put something out there. But the more I thought about it, the more I figured that, well, why, I should put something out there. Because how will I ever know if anybody likes what I do? And then again, like, if people hate what I do, what do I care? Especially on the internet. Like, if they like it, fantastic. If they hate it, yeah, whatever. I mean, it's not worth it. Like, it's not worth anything to me. If you don't like it, and you... That's fine. I mean, I know I'm not a very talented singer. I'm not, like... I'm not, what's that? Whatever. I'm not an opera singer. I'm like, I'm barely even a folk singer. I'm not that great at singing. I can do it to a limited extent. I can't carry a melody with my voice. Never without accompaniment. And it's okay. And it's just something I'm trying to do. I'm trying to put myself out there. Like, you ain't alone there, Jake. We're all trying to improve ourselves. Typically. At least if people are dutiful human beings. Because it's, every human being's duty to learn and improve. It's something my dad told me. So it is the duty of every human being to learn and improve themselves that way. And if they stop doing that, they are derelict in their duty. And it's something that stuck with me. He's not dead or anything, it's just something that sticks with me in my head. There you go, Jake. I mean, guaranteed you. Take your videos. Okay, you're definitely one of my favorite presenters. I need to use my lighter this time because the magic is closer. But you are one of my favorite presenters. Just because you're a real dude. You know? Okay. I'm talking like dude, like the Big Lebowski. Yeah, you're at that level. In my mind. No, I love Jeff Bridges. The teachings of the dude rank high in my books. And you are right up there. The way you present your videos is perfectly natural, just like a conversation. I dig that. It's good. It's good to have a guy out there like you, because it gives people confidence to do this. Like, it was watching your videos actually, like you and a couple other guys, it inspired me to take this up, just to do it, because. You weren't doing anything. There was no gimmick there. It was just you doing what you being you on camera. And that's something. Alright. I think I've said enough. Anyhow. Like Senderdale. Give it a chance, people. Don't take that soap in. This is a terrible thing. Your mouth ain't gonna froth up. Alright. Until next time, enjoy every sandwich.